let me talk about the functions of liver. The liver is involved in the metabolism of carbohydrates, fats and proteins. Now coming to carbohydrate metabolism, liver converts glucose into glycogen and stores this glycogen in liver. During fasting, releases glucose by breaking down this glycogen, a process called glycogenolysis, contributed by both glucagon and catecholamines. Liver can also form glucose from lactate and pyruvate, as well as from fats. Liver not only can form glucose from fats, but even from glucogenic amino acids like alanine and glutamine, a process called gluconeogenesis, contributed by glucocorticoids and especially happens in fasting times. Liver thus stores glucose as glycogen and is major player in maintaining stable glucose concentration by process of glycogenesis, glycogenolysis and gluconeogenesis. Thus involved in synthesis, storage and release of glucose. Normally about 75 grams of glycogen is found in the liver and depleted by 24 to 48 hours of starvation. Normally also 10 to 15 grams of albumin are produced daily. Now coming to fat metabolism. Liver is involved in synthesis of cholesterol, lipoproteins, especially very low density lipoproteins, phospholipids, and other lipoproteins like HDL, IDL, and LDL. However, other lipoproteins like chylomicrons is formed in intestinal cells. Lipoproteins are like trucks that load fats, that load triglycerides, phospholipids and cholesterol and carry them to different tissues. The main truck is very low density lipoprotein that leaves from the liver. Very low density lipoproteins circulate to the periphery, where lipoprotein lipase hydrolyzes the triglycerides that it carries to free fatty acids, allowing free fatty acids and glycerol to be taken up by the peripheral tissues. Due to unloading of triglycerides and glycerol from the very low density lipoproteins, the very low density lipoproteins become intermediate density lipoproteins and low density lipoproteins. So what I mean to say is that very low density lipoproteins that are formed in the liver carry the fats in the form of triglycerides and glycerol and is being taken to the different tissues of the body, where the free fatty acids is taken up by the cells, and the very low density lipoproteins, because of this unloading, becomes intermediate density lipoproteins and low density lipoproteins. Both intermediate density lipoproteins and low density lipoproteins mainly contain cholesterol. IDL and LDL return back to liver, where they are taken up by liver and reused. Liver also gathers free fatty acids from diet and breaks them down to acetyl coenzyme A to form again triglycerides in the liver. Phospholipids and cholesterol are also formed from acetyl coenzyme A. 70% of cholesterol is produced by liver. Acetyl coenzyme A in the liver is also converted to acetoacetic acid, which circulates to different tissues of the body as acetoacetic acid, beta hydroxybutyrate, and acetone, that is ketone bodies. These are converted back to acetyl coenzyme A in cells. Any increase in these products result in ketosis. Liver also synthesizes fats from carbohydrates and proteins. Liver uses cholesterol and phospholipids to make bile. One thing you should remember here, that triglycerides contain three fatty acids and one glycerol, while as phospholipids contain two fatty acids and one phosphate group and glycerol. Now coming to protein metabolism, most of the body proteins and enzymes, except immunoglobulins, are synthesized and secreted by liver. One of the most abundant serum proteins formed in liver is albumin. Impaired liver function results in decreased serum albumin. Some of the proteins synthesized by liver include following coagulation factors. Factor 1, that is fibrinogen. Factor 2, prothrombin. And factor 5, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th, and 13th. Most of these clotting factors are vitamin K dependent. Liver also synthesizes protein C, protein S, and antithrombin. Two important transaminase enzymes produced in the liver are aspartate transaminase, also known as serum glutamic oxaloacetic transaminase, and alanine transaminase, or serum glutamate pyruvate transaminase. They are both produced in the liver. The liver makes proteins from amino acids. Liver can make proteins from other sources also, like glucose and fatty acids. The enzymes alanine and aspartate transaminase are used for formation of proteins. A high concentration of these enzymes in the blood indicates liver damage, since these enzymes are leaked in blood when liver inflammation is on. Amino acids that come from dietary sources enter the liver and are first broken down to keto acids. Keto acids can be recycled in the body for generation of energy and production of glucose or fat or other amino acids. This breakdown of amino acids to a keto acids occurs in the liver by a process known as transamination. Liver converts ammonia into urea, that is ammonia metabolism and excretion. Ammonia is formed by metabolism of proteins or amino acids. Liver and other tissues remove the amine groups of the amino acids and convert them into ammonia. So liver and other tissues remove amine groups of amino acids and convert them into ammonia. So it is deamination of amino acids that result in the formation of alpha keto acids and ammonia. Blood ammonia level is 10 to 60 microgram per 100 ml. Ammonia is also produced by action of intestinal bacteria on dietary amino acids or proteins. Ammonia is released from monoamines, that is sympathetic amines, by action of monoamine oxidase enzymes, as well as released during purine and pyrimidine catabolism. Ammonia is toxic to central nervous system, thus once formed should be immediately removed from the blood. Therefore, liver removes it and converts it to urea, which is less toxic, water soluble and easily excreted in the urine. Mechanism of ammonia intoxication. Ammonia depletes alpha ketoglutaric acid from brain. This leads to inhibition of Krebs cycle, which is the main source of energy, leading to neurological manifestations. The liver can form plasma proteins at a maximum rate of 15 to 50 grams per day. Therefore, even if as much as half the plasma proteins are lost from the body, they can be replaced in 1 or 2 weeks' time. Liver also has got storage function. So liver stores vitamins A, D, E, K, vitamin B12, iron as ferritin, copper, blood. Liver is the site for erythropoiesis during fetal life. Sufficient quantities of vitamin A can be stored to prevent vitamin A deficiency for as long as 10 months. And sufficient vitamin D can be stored to prevent deficiency for 3 to 4 months. And enough vitamin B12 can be stored to last for at least 1 year or maybe several years. The hepatic cells contain large amounts of protein called apoferritin, which is capable of combining with iron to form ferritin and is stored in this form in the hepatic cells until needed elsewhere. When the iron in the circulating body fluids reaches a low level, the ferritin releases the iron. Thus, the apoferritin and ferritin system of the liver acts as a blood iron buffer as well as iron storage medium. Detoxification. Liver serves as a gatekeeper. Every substance absorbed in the intestinal tract passes first through liver, where these substances are being filtered, cleaned, purified, and then sent to different tissues. Detoxification of drugs, poisons, and metabolic products like ammonia, alcohol, and of hormones like cortisol, aldosterone, insulin, glucagon, and testosterone happen by binding these materials so as to inactivate them and chemically modify them for excretion through urine and feces. Liver secretes bile, and the components of bile are bile salts and bile acids. Bile is made up of bile salts, bile pigments and other substances, dissolved in alkaline electrolyte solution. Bile acids are produced by hepatocytes from cholesterol. They are cholic acid and chinodeoxycholic acid. Bile acids are then conjugated with taurine and glycine along with the sodium or potassium to be converted to bile salts like sodium taurocholate or glycocholate or potassium taurocholate and potassium glycocholate. The two most important bile pigments are bilirubin and biliverdin, formed by decomposition of porphyrin ring that contain four pyrrole rings. Bilirubin is brownish yellow pigment that gives feces its characteristic color and is the end product of breakdown of heme from destroyed red blood, while as biliverdin is green. When bilirubin and biliverdin get conjugated, we call them as pigments. Bilirubin is transported to liver along with plasma proteins called as unconjugated bilirubin. Protein gets separated and bilirubin gets conjugated with glucuronic acid, so they become conjugated. In intestine, bacteria act and 50% of it is converted to bilinogen. Most of bilinogen enters liver through anterior hepatic circulation and is re-excreted through bile. About 5% of urobilinogen is excreted by kidney through urine. Some unabsorbed part is excreted through feces as stercobilinogen. This gives yellow color to urine and feces. Other components of bile are water, bilirubin, cholesterol, fatty acids, lecithin, sodium, potassium. Functions of bile salts are emulsification, micelle formation, and digestion of fats. Laxative action, bacteriostatic action, absorption of fat-soluble vitamins. Major route for loss of cholesterol from body, lubricating function, and anterior hepatic circulation. Liver also produces red blood cells in the first trimester of the fetus. Phospholipids, which are mainly lecithin, phospholipids and bicarbonate and other ions. Liver also produces insulin-like growth factor. So insulin produces red blood cells, phospholipids containing lecithin and bicarbonate, and it also produces insulin-like growth factor. Liver also produces little erythropoietin. Liver protects from harmful effects of bacteria and other organisms, a function performed by Kupffer cells that ingest bacteria or other foreign materials from the blood. There is a substance which is called as choline, and choline is protective for liver. It is a constituent of lecithin, a key building block of cell membranes, important for cell formation and tissue growth and repair. Choline is similar to B vitamins and is necessary for proper liver function, metabolism of fats and proteins, and for normal functioning of the nerves. Choline is extremely important in brain and memory function and is helpful in treating Alzheimer's disease. Choline prevents gallstone formation, high blood pressure, atherosclerosis, kidney damage, nephritis, glaucoma, and myasthenia gravis. It is also used in treatment of bipolar depression. Choline food sources are banana, cauliflower, flax seed, leafy green vegetables, legumes, nuts, oranges, peanuts, potatoes, seeds, tomatoes, vegetable oils, and whole grains.